On Tuesday, I had an unforgettable lunch with Hardy, who showed me Mellstock, his birthplace, Rainbarrow, and Egdon in general. Hardy knows my planets, because he heard them on a gramophone belonging to T.E. Lawrence, who was in camp on Egdon Heath in the Tank Corps. I've promised him to go up to Rainbarrow by night. He's sorry I'm seeing it in summer weather, and wants me to come again in November. As I imagined the restless characters that roamed this wild place in the novels, the seeds of a tone poem began slowly to develop.
The untamable thing that Egdon Heath now was, it always had been. The sea changed, the fields, the villages and the people changed, yet Egdon remained, affording a livelihood to only a few. The uplands of Egdon commanded the valley of the great dairies, but not a plough had ever disturbed a grain of that stubborn soil. haggard Egdon. It was a place perfectly accordant with man's nature, neither ghastly, hateful, nor ugly, neither commonplace, unmeaning, nor tame, but like man, slighted and enduring, and withal singularly colossal and mysterious in its swarthy monotony. The storm was its lover, and the wind its friend. During tempests and mists, it became the home of strange phantoms.
When a native of Egdon walked the heath alone, the past seized upon him with its shadowy hand.
On certain friends I had not seen for years past did I call, and then on others who had been the oldest friends of all. I spoke to one or other of them by mound and stone and tree of things we had done ere days were dim, but they spoke not to me.
His doomed lovers met their end at Shadwater Pool.
Thank you. in the twilight, the great glory of the Egdon Waste began.
If anyone knew the heath well, it was he. He was permeated with its scenes, with its substance, and with its odors. His eyes had first opened thereon. But now...
On a night in November of weariful cares, a frail, aged figure ascended those stairs for the very last time. All gone is life's prime, all vanished his vigor and fine, forceful frame. Thus, last, one November ascended that figure upstairs.